Hello, this is Cinnamon with the How to Draw the Human Body Pear-Shaped Tutorial. We start with a circle and a line down the middle to make sure we keep everything even, and then the upside down heart, which helps signify the chest size, or also just your bust in general. Then I do two circles, one for the waist and one for the hips. Two circles for the thighs, so then you can make sure they're around even size. I drew the knees a bit too big, but I went back and fixed that clearly, as you see, and did the knees a bit smaller than the thighs. The looping around the circle helps make a perfect size for the thighs, and the spacing between the thighs and the knees and then the knees and the feet are around the same size. The feet are just usually just triangles, so I think it'll be fine with that one. I usually do extra lines for the shoulders to help make sure, but this drawing, the shoulders were pretty small, so I apologize for that. I usually always freestyle the hands, so there's not much advice I could give you there unless I do a whole nother video on it, which I probably will. The same thing I do with the thighs is the same thing I do with the arms. I do the loops, and they're around the same distance each. Excuse me for the audio and the cutting off between that. I don't know how to change it. It's just the program I'm using. Then I start overlining everything and deciding the final shape I want. Sometimes I go a bit over because I realize, oh, this part is probably too skinny or too thick, and then I just change up the lines a little bit or just ignore the lines and completely go over them. I end up changing that their left foot or the right, as you look at it from here, into forward shape so that it makes more sense because you can't really see her turning her thigh. I go in with simple face details, which I'll do another video for, and just start finalizing everything. Then I pick out her hairstyle with some bangs and some curly hairs, which is not too curly but more wavy. I'll also be coloring the hair in this video, and I can give a few tips on that too. But this is practically just the simple body shape that I use. So if you want to stop here and that's all you want, but I'm also going to be doing coloring and line arting now. So there's about to be a transition into the line art, and I'm going to color everything. And we're back with that, and the line art materials are going to be on the side. All my other materials from this point on is going to be on the right side of the video. You don't have to use this kind of pen to make any drawing, no matter what pen you use, it probably will work as long as it doesn't smear. I went in and colored the bunny suit because that's the outfit I chose, so then you could see the most skin as possible, so then you could see how to color every single part or how I do it. So I go in with the base layer of this tannish color, which I'll put on the side because I don't remember off the top of my head at the moment. And I go in with some pink. Pink and purple are the best things I use for shading. It really helps give more definition. It's better than using browns because you gotta give the skin a little bit of color. Even with darker skin, sometimes I don't always use browns. I try to go on with the darker purple because it gives them more flesh-like tones. When I'm blending the pink and the tan, I just go in with the tan to smooth it all out so then it becomes more even. Then the purple, I blend out with the pink. So you always go to the next line. You keep it in order. I don't know if everyone understands that, but you see I have the color swatch on the side. Not in order, but you know, I forgot to swatch the purple, but I will at the end, don't worry. I always spend a lot of time blending, and sometimes I overblend. If you overblend, you'll start to damage the paper, but this paper is very thick. I'm using a watercolor paper, because I didn't have any marker paper on me, so this has to work. But it didn't come up or anything, because watercolor paper is very strong, so I recommend something very thick for markers. If not, put a sheet or two of paper behind it, especially if you're doing a lot of blending. Or it will sink through onto your table and stain it. Don't ask how I know, because I've done it a million times. The lighting is also what affects where you put your shading. This one I did a simple front-facing light, so it wouldn't be too hard, and plus, it's the most simple way of shading, honestly, from what I've seen. Because you don't have to worry too much about darkening certain spots, it's just simple. When you get more advanced, you can start going from any other angle, or even from the light from the back, so half of it is all darkened. It would be cool. I might do a drawing like that just to see how it's like, because I haven't done one yet, because I get a little bit too nervous. As you see right now, I'm going over with the base color, again, over the arms, the chest, which I'll start my simple pink shading, and then I always put a lot of shading in the hands. Hands have a lot more pinkish tones, so I always put a lot of pink in the hands. That's just me, may not be you. I also shade the collarbone and leave a little highlight at the top where the light hits it, of course. And then some people actually put makeup there to make it more defined. So sometimes you might want to draw it a bit more defined. Depends on you as a person. It depends on the reference you're using. This one, I didn't use a reference, so I just went with whatever I wanted. Now I'm shading more with my purple. You're also going to want to shade under the hair Even if it's not a lot of hair, you still want to get a little bit of shading in there on the skin to make sure it looks more defined and real. This drawing isn't anywhere near real. It's just my own style. At the moment, it may get more realistic later, I don't know. The face, I always be careful when coloring in the nose or shading the nose because it always seems to smear. Same thing with the lips. Be very careful. I always make my lips really dark, so I use the line art to make a black lip for the top lip, and I color the bottom in with purple. It kind of helps give it a bit more definition. And then I always do purple around the eyes too. Next, I'm gonna be finally coloring the hair, which you're gonna see the materials also on the side for that. Same thing with the markers from last time. I go in with the lightest shade I'm using. I only use two markers for this generally, which I am in this video only using two markers. And I leave white spaces for highlights, which I'll go over again with gel pens later on. So I fill in all the highlights. Usually I do two, one towards the bottom of the hair and one towards the top, but that's just for this length. The longer the hair, the difference gonna be. Same thing with the shorter the hair, the difference it's gonna be. Sometimes I leave a white spacing around the hair and then go in with it with the white gel pen, but I didn't for this. And it's okay to mess up. If you get the white gel pen, it really helps a lot. I highly recommend the jelly roll. I used 01, I think. I'll have to go back and look. It's not going to be on the hair materials on the side anyway, so you can see it there if I'm wrong. I went in with a darker brown to shade it. I usually start out with the golden blonde to just signify the highlights and give it a bit more color, because if you use just a lighter brown, it may look a bit more flat. And make sure the colors aren't too close together. Give them a little bit of a jump. Or you could use three markers so then it's in the middle for each, so then you won't have a problem with it. This one I might have or should have gone in with a little bit of a darker brown later on, but I didn't, regrettably. And now I just go in with a gel pen soon after and go back to fix everything, showing you the markers at the moment so then you can see exactly which ones I use, which will be on the side because I didn't think you could read them and you guys probably clearly can't. So I'm just going in with any final details now. I hope you enjoyed this video. I know I haven't posted since beginning of quarantine, but I just have no motivation to. But I've been really improving my art skills, and I hope you guys enjoyed this video and it's really helpful. I'm gonna be sharing it to a few people that might help, hopefully. Again, sorry about the little voice jumps in this video. It's hard to voice record with the app I'm using because I'm doing it on my phone because I don't have all that expensive setup stuff. But now I'm just gonna show you everything and like and subscribe. Tell me what you thought of this video. Thank you. Bye.